Welcome back. You might have missed it heading into the long holiday weekend, but a who's who of New Hampshire politics, past and present, convened in Concord June 30th for the unveiling of a new statue on the statehouse grounds. Governor John Gilbert Winant, long forgotten, is receiving a long overdue honor for having lived an extraordinary life in extraordinary times. He is one of the most consequential New Hampshire political figures of the 20th century. Now, Governor John Winant has joined the pantheon of leaders memorialized in bronze at the Statehouse.
He has been described by many as the most famous granite stater that nobody knows. And finally, we get to give him and his family their rightful due.
Winant served three terms as governor, two during the 1930s at the height of the Great Depression. A progressive Republican, he backed Roosevelt's New Deal to help New Hampshire's poor. The president appointed him as the first head of the newly formed Social Security Board and then gave him the assignment that would define his legacy, ambassador to the United Kingdom. At the height of the Blitz, when Nazi bombs rained down on Great Britain, Winant arrived, telling the British people there was no place in the world he'd rather be.
His warmth and his compassion and his determination to stand with them and share their dangers was the first tangible sign for the British that America and its people really cared what happened to them. And so he became a symbol of the best side of America.
Winant shared the dangers of wartime London, providing crucial support and forging the bonds of alliance before America officially joined the fight. He wasn't a great speechmaker or a big personality. Rather, historians say he had a gift for working in small groups, winning friends and support. The new statue is meant to evoke his personable, down-to-earth nature.
This is the type of person that you need who can just see the good qualities of people and work together to find a common goal. And I think this is the type of person he was.
After the war, Winant struggled, eventually taking his own life in 1947. He was buried at the St. Paul's School in Concord, and his memory faded into history. But now, this American hero is once again standing with the people, extending a hand in friendship.
This memorial we are dedicating today to Governor John Winant is far more than what he would have ever wanted, but far less than what he deserves.
That wraps up this edition of Close Up New Hampshire. Thanks for watching. We'll be back next week. Have a great Sunday.